The third meeting of the National Space Council, seeking a partnership to power our gateway, and an educational activity that's quite a blast. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Administrator Jim Bridenstine attended the third meeting of the National Space Council June 18th at the White House. President Trump opened the meeting by signing Space Policy Directive 3, which directs the U.S. to lead space traffic management and mitigate the effects of space debris. During the meeting, which was led by Vice President Mike Pence, Bridenstine reported on NASA's progress in implementing Space Policy Directive 1, which directs NASA to return U.S. astronauts to the moon and eventually send humans to Mars.
The architecture that we're building now is entirely different than any architecture we've ever built before in an effort to get to the moon. And the reason is we have more capabilities now than we've ever had as a nation.
On June 21st, we announced plans to seek a public-private industry partnership for a high-power solar electric propulsion spacecraft to provide power, controls, and communications for the first element of our planned lunar exploration platform known as the Gateway. Built with commercial and international partners, the Gateway will become the orbital outpost for robotic and human exploration operations on and near the moon and beyond, including Mars.
This is our opportunity to have more access to more parts of the moon than ever before. When you land on the surface of the moon, you're in one spot on the surface of the moon. But what we want is we want access to the entire moon.
A new multi-agency report released June 20th details plans for the U.S. response to near-Earth objects that could pose a hazard to Earth. Titled National Near-Earth Object Preparedness Strategy and Action Plan, the document identifies actions to enhance the federal government's coordination and preparedness posture during the next 10 years to address potential hazards posed by near-Earth objects. For information about NASA's Planetary Defense Coordination Office, visit nasa.gov/planetary-defense. Our Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia held its annual Rocket Week June 15th through 22nd. It's an opportunity for students and instructors from across the country to learn more about rocketry basics and build experiments for flying on a NASA suborbital rocket through their Rock On and RockSat-C programs. Rocket Week is one of many events we sponsor to stimulate student interest in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, or STEM careers. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.